All right, so we got three exciting communities we're checking out today. They're right in Summerfield, right next to the villages. And we went through, we got B-roll, tried to get B-roll of all three. We did get the boot in
what? Stonecrest.
Stonecrest. So we didn't get the inside of the amenities. We talked to the HOA and they may approve us to go back. But in the meantime, we'll give you what we got.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to sit down and compare these three communities as great options, as alternatives to the villages. If you want to be right here, but you want something a little bit more affordable and
no CDD.
No CDD. And just obviously just a little bit more low key than the villages. Right?
Yep. But still have access right across the street for most everything you could even need. Yeah, cool. These are cool options.
They are really cool options. So we're going to actually sit down and talk about them at the Links, which is the golf course and restaurant in
Spruce Creek South.
Spruce Creek South.
Beautiful and, little community.
And we'll meet with Kaylin, who's our expert up here.
Yes, let's go meet Kaylin.
Sorry about the interruption. So two things I have to say real quick. So at the end of this, I'm going to put up the comparison of these three communities on the screen. We have a PDF that has the home prices, HOA, some stats. So you guys will find that interesting. But the second thing is on Monday, October... What day is Monday? Monday, October 4th, we're going to do a live Q&A at 7 p.m. Eastern Time here in Florida. So if you guys are interested in joining in on that, come join us. We're going to kind of keep it generic to 55 plus in general. It's going to be myself and my mom, and it'll be kind of the first test run for a live where we want to start to do these with specific areas, specific communities. So let's say that you're interested in the Ocala area. We're going to have one of our experts in Ocala come on and be able to answer your questions about specific communities in Ocala or general things about the Ocala area, so on and so forth. I think that'll add a lot of value to the conversation. But anyways, sorry, back to the video.
You're welcome.
Hello.
What we're going to do is just sort of tell the folks out there there are three affordable options right outside the gates of the villages. And actually, the villages doesn't have gates, so that's not even fair to say. But affordable options around the villages. So we're going to compare.
What are the three communities?
So Spruce Creek South, which is where we are right now.
Mm-hmm.
Spruce Creek Golf and Country Club. And then we've also got Stonecrest. Stonecrest is still building, so if you're looking for a new home, that's a really good option. And the only option in this area.
Yes, other than the villages.
Other than the villages.
Yeah.
So, specifically, there was two people that said they wish they knew about these communities before they had bought the villages.
That is correct.
So, that being said, if you're checking out the villages, there's really no reason not to come just look at these while you're here.
100%. And the thing is, and it's the village's lifestyle, right? That lifestyle visit that people get on, and they get caught up in it. And it's pretty darn cool, it is. But they don't tell you about your options in the area that you could actually visit, which is the whole reason for the Explore YouTube.
Knowledge is power, and you may still love the villages and want to
exactly,
do it, but not,
right.
Yeah, you gotta
exactly.
So then these three options really end up being more affordable and don't have CDDs.
That's correct.
Very correct.
All right.
And they're all gated,
and
so you have
gated.
Security in all of them.
Let's start with Stonecrest.
Okay. Oh, let me take this so I don't look like a granny. Okay.
You do not look like a granny, that's for sure. None of us do. We're 30.
That's right.
We just look out.
I'm 28. So about Stonecrest. So Stonecrest is a great size. It's 2,200 homes, and the price range is from 190 to 500,000. So, you know, some really affordable, some not so affordable. You've got single family homes, and you do have a few villas in there, but they're really just resale, so not many. The cool thing about Stonecrest is that they're still building. They don't have a ton of lots left, but they're still building. So if you want a new home, you know, it's a very viable option and the only option in this area, except for the villages.
So of course I sold back in the day, and it was Armstrong Homes that was the initial developer, but now they've sold their last lots to Lennar.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yep, Lennar. And Lennar has they're doing the 27 lots, and I believe that they're all started. So hopefully in 6 months.
Maybe even some inventory.
Maybe some inventory, which is really hard to find right now for all the buyers. So could be a good option. Just buy new. You don't have to worry about it.
So Stonecrest, I know one of the claims to fame is the fact that you can ride your golf cart to Walmart, back to some of those shops in those strip areas.
Right.
And there's a sneaky way somehow to get into the villages on your golf cart.
Right.
From there.
But
it's my understanding, but we can't confirm that.
We can't deny it either. So, you know. Basically, we don't know, but that's what we heard.
But it was a beautiful golf course, and they did change. They used to have a 9-hole as well as the 18, and they took the 9-hole, and they're putting another 5 homes on that. So
right.
It's just one 18-hole golf course at this right. point.
And they've just redone it. It's stunning. So beautiful golf course there.
Let's dive into what's next?
Spruce Creek Golf and Country Club.
All right.
Right. Spruce Creek Golf and Country Club is a Del Webb community, and they actually have 36 holes of golf there, so it's kind of a golfer's paradise. The prices, they've got about 3,250 homes, and the prices range from $220,000 up to $500,000, so pretty good space. I'll tell you, finding one at the 220 is pretty hard to do, though.
Yeah,
especially now.
Yeah.
So it might be a fixer up in that price range at this point. They also have some villas, not a lot, but they do have some villas there. And the HOA for the single family homes is 250. I'm sorry, I can't see. Is 150, and the villa is 268. So, and that's because the villas have
some shared expenses.
Expenses, right.
Like the escrow for the roof and some maintenance and things like that.
Mm-hmm. And they finished building there in 2007. So mm-hmm. from 1996 to 2007. So, you know, they're 14 years old, but that's nothing.
Well, and some of them have been updated, and it's got a beautiful entry. And actually their fitness and their indoor-outdoor pool is really super nice.
It is super nice, yeah. It's a very pretty community. One of my favorites to show, because it makes such a great impression. Every time I've walked in the clubhouse in the Spruce Creek Golf and Country Club, it has been full of people mm-hmm. doing one thing or another, and they're all very friendly and, you know, want to talk to you. So.
Yeah, I think with the larger communities, there's just naturally more people. And Del Webb is kind of known, you know, they're a big developer of 55 mm-hmm. plus communities, so they're very well known.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So Spruce Creek South, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So Spruce Creek South is, it's a great little community. It's very laid back. The price points is a little bit lower than the others. They start anywhere from about 130 and go up to about 300,000. Your homes are going to range from as small as 800 square feet, and that's going to be your villas, though. And then your single family homes are up to almost 2,000
mm-hmm.
square feet.
That is one of the difference in here. It's got sort of smaller homes, but the lots are so much bigger. There's just a lot of space
they
in
are.
Here.
I think most of them are about a quarter acre here, so that's pretty good size.
It is a good size.
Yeah, especially for a 55 plus community.
With the smaller houses, though, that limits. So if somebody wants 2,800 square feet, you're just not going to find that in Spruce Creek South.
No, you're just not going to find it here.
And I am going to say it's super clean, and everybody's been super friendly in here as well.
Mm-hmm. They are. Very nice.
This is you get that. When you come tour, you pick up on the culture that develops within the communities. Typically starts from management, HOA.
Yes, and shout out to Jill, who is marvelous. And
yeah, love Jill.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone in here has just been extremely friendly.
Yeah. And it's so clean.
Yeah.
And it's gorgeous. This is a beautiful place to do some biz.
Mm-hmm. This is a cool option. When you guys start boiling down and find those spots that you want to tour, you have to see the community because you'll pick up on the culture really quick.
That's exactly right. Yep. We can do these videos for you all day long.
Right.
But then you make an appointment with Kaylin or one of our team, and they just will go in and out. You'll see exactly what we're trying to show you in person. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
All right, I appreciate you guys tuning in. Hopefully that video was helpful. You guys know the drill. Listen, I have to give credit to my mom. She's created an incredible team of agents. If you guys want to get connected with someone in Florida that specializes in 55 plus communities, knows them in and out, visit the website explore55plus.com. You can email, call us, and hopefully I'll see you guys on the live stream. That'll be a lot of fun. October 4th at 7 p.m. We're going to be hanging out with you guys. It'll be cool to hear your feedback. And I mean, really just have a conversation with everyone that's been watching the channel. So, see you guys then. Thank you for watching.